In this video, I will discuss about 802.1x protocol. What is 802.1x authentication and how it works? IEEE 802.1x is a standard port-based access control and authentication protocol. It is ideal for restricting authorized access through publicly available LAN devices, such as switches and wireless access points. There are three main components: the supplicant, authenticator, and the authentication server. The supplicant is the user or client allow it to access the network. This is usually the 802.1x enabled port on the device that requests access to LAN and switch services and responds to requests from the switch. In the figure, this PC running 802.1x compliant client software. While the authenticator is any network device such as a wireless access point or an Ethernet switch, the switch controls physical access to the network based on the authentication status of the client. The switch acts as a proxy between the client and the authentication server. It requests identifying information from the client, verifies that information with the authentication server, and relays a response to the client. And the authentication server, or AS, is a trusted server that does the authentication mechanism of the network access by receiving, processing, and responding to various requests from the clients. And also the one who decides and tells the authenticator to either allow or deny the access and apply various settings to the user. The authentication server performs the actual authentication of the client. The authentication server validates the identity of the client and notifies the switch about whether the client is authorized to access the LAN and switch services. Because the switch acts as the proxy, the authentication service is transparent to the client. So, the authentication method begins when the client device requests to connect to the network. The authenticator receives the request and creates a virtual port with the supplicant. The authenticator limits traffic to authentication data to the server. Some negotiation takes place, which the client may send a message. The access point sends a request identity message. The client's response packet with the client's identity is proxied to the authentication server by the authenticator. The authentication server challenges the client to prove itself and may send its credentials to prove itself to the client. The client checks the server's credentials and then sends its credentials to the server to prove itself. The authentication server accepts or rejects the client's request for connection. If the end user is accepted, the authenticator changes the virtual port with the end user to an authorized state, allowing full network access to that end user. I hope this information is useful to you, and I want to thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel.